Born of fire, the Galapagos Islands lie 600 miles off the Ecuadorian coast, making them a world of their own. Best known for being the cradle of evolution, the islands were the site of the famous visit by Charles Darwin in 1835. Volcanic peaks and turquoise waters paint the scenery for one of the most eccentric and captivating performances in the Pacific, and possibly the planet. The Galapagos Science Center is located on San Cristobal Island within a tranquil harbor village that is surrounded by native vegetation, spectacular views of the ocean, and agricultural highlands. With an abundance of biodiversity of flora and fauna, endemic species that occur in the Galapagos and no other place on Earth, and an expanding human dimension that imposes direct and indirect impacts in Darwin's paradise, there is something new to be discovered every day.
Project is allowing us to look at the beaches and how their topography changes over time, which both allows us to understand how the long-term vulnerability of the beach might be. Being able to conduct research actively here in these laboratories that have an amazing capacity is completely essential to doing research in the Galapagos. Drinking water, source water, and beach water on the islands with the goal of just getting a baseline overall understanding of the water quality here. And we look at both chemical, physical, and microbiological parameters to just give us a whole picture of what the water quality is looking like, with the goal of having this be sustainable and having this be a long-term consistent measurement so that we have constant monitoring of the water quality, especially as new projects like the wastewater treatment system and the drinking water treatment system are implemented, so that years down the road we can look back and compare the effectiveness of these systems.
So being here in the Galapagos, I think it's something that I've realized that it's something that I'm very passionate about. I think being able to bring in science and people and kind of connect the two is something that I really enjoy doing. I like trying to make science relatable, and the Galapagos is a place where that's very easy to do if people are really interested in the science you're doing.
I'm a biological anthropologist studying human health in the Galapagos for my dissertation PhD in anthropology at the University of North Carolina. And I study under the direction of Dr. Amanda Thompson and Dr. Peggy Bentley. Studying human health is really important in the Galapagos because what we have here is a dual burden of both developed and developing world's health problems. So on the island, they're experiencing a lot of overnutrition, which is resulting in overweight and obesity. And then also there's poor water quality and fecal contamination in the household water, so everyone is forced to drink bottled water. So I'm interested in looking at how this dual burden impacts immune function and intestinal health in moms and kids.
UNC Galapagos.